Dear friends, today let us continue the discussion on the de Broglie hypothesis. Let us take few more problems on de Broglie hypothesis. I'll just dictate the problem which was taken yesterday. Once again, I'll take dictate it. The problem of this: the radiation of wavelength 1800 angstrom is incident on a photosensitive material of work function 5 electron volt. Find the de Broglie wavelength of emitted photoelectron. As I repeatedly saying, in any problem, the first step is the understanding the problem, and then we supposed to note down the given data. Okay? Here, this problem is somewhat related to de Broglie hypothesis and also related to photoelectric effect. You just see here there is a photoelectric effect setup. Say here there is a photoelectric effect setup. Okay, in which there is a photosensitive material somewhere here. Okay, this is what the photosensitive material. Here the another electrode is there to collect the photoelectron. Say this is the another electrode, this is the photosensitive material. Here we are incidenting the external radiation. Okay, here we are incidenting the external radiation. Okay, I'll take the radiation here. Okay, this is what the external radiation incidence. See, the wavelength of the external radiation is given. Okay, you may take this as, say, incidented radiation, no? Therefore, I will take it as a lambda I for my convenience. How much it is? This is what the value given, that is 1800 angstrom is what the incidenting wavelength. Okay, next, this photosensitive material is there, no? This photosensitive material is having a work function, where W is what the work function. In PO classes, you are using the same denotion, W I said. Okay, how much it is? This is having a work function of 5 electron volt. Fine. Now, there is a photoelectron emission. The electrons are generated. Say, these are all the electrons. Okay, these electrons are going in this way towards another electrode, the positive electrode, you say. These electrons are actually having certain wavelengths. Okay, the wavelength of the electrons that to be determined. Okay, these electrons, I'll take it as I say electrons E, are having certain wavelength. I'll take it as I say lambda. Okay, this lambda to be determined. Okay, now first let us note down these quantities separately. Okay, first I'll take the given data, the solution. First, I'll note down the given data. Given. The first is the incidenting wavelength, that is lambda I, that is equal to 1800 angstrom. Always the given data to be taken in SI unit, no? Therefore, we will express this in meter. 1800 into 10 power minus 10 meter. Okay, next is the work function. The work function is equal to 5 electron volt. Take this work function in joules, that is 5 into 1.602 into 10 power minus 19 joules. Tell me this value, how much W is? Please calculate this, let me know this value, how much it is.
Eight point zero one
into 10 power minus 19 joules. Okay, this is what the W is. Okay, this is what the W is. Okay, next, what we supposed to calculate? We supposed to calculate though de Broglie wavelength of the electrons emitted, that is lambda to be determined. Okay, this is what the wavelength of photoelectrons. The lambda is what the wavelength of the photoelectrons. Fine. Okay, now you start with the solution part now. First, what will you do? You are going with the well-known photoelectric equation proposed by Einstein. Okay, the photoelectric equation is, write down, we know that photoelectric equation is photoelectric effect equation as, you just remind me the equation. What is that equation? Tell me that equation. What is photoelectric equation? The equation was the incidented energy, that is E, that is equal to the work function plus half mv square. That's what the kinetic energy of the photoelectron. This is what the fundamental equation. Okay, here this E is incidented energy. This is what the work function. Work function of photosensitive material. PS material means photosensitive material. What this kinetic energy? This is kinetic energy of photoelectrons. You know, the photoelectrons are having certain energy. That energy is for the kinetic energy. Here is, what is the physical meaning of this equation? The incidented energy in this setup. Okay, incidented energy is equivalent to the work function of the photosensitive material plus kinetic energy. Some of the incidented energy is used to remove an electron from this photosensitive material, and the remaining energy from this external source will be acquired by the photoelectrons. Okay, the electrons are going with certain speed. No, that is because of the external extra energy from the external source. That's all. Okay. Now, this is what the fundamental equation. You just conveniently rearrange this equation. Okay. Here, first let's find out the kinetic energy of the photoelectrons. Okay. Let's find out the kinetic energy of the photoelectrons, because the lambda is given. That is, lambda I is given. I mean, the lambda I, if I have, then obviously I can get the value of that overall energy. The work function is also known. Therefore, kinetic energy, let's find it out. Shall we call this kinetic energy as some Ek for our convenience? The Ek is the denotation. Remember, the kinetic energy of the photoelectron, I'll denote it by Ek. Okay, or even simply you can take it as a E. But to avoid the confusion, here you may take it as a incidented energy as EI. The W is the work function, kinetic energy Ek is there. Okay, therefore, in the next step, you write this as the kinetic energy of photoelectron Ek, that is equal to EI minus W. EI minus W. The EI means basically it is h nu, or it is equal to hc by lambda. Okay, how shall I write this lambda now? Is it simply a lambda or lambda something? With respect to our assumption, I can take this as lambda I, that is what the incidented energy, minus W. Substitute approximately H value can be taken as 6.63, or else it can be 6.626 itself. Let me approximate it. Into 10 power minus 34 is there. C is the velocity of light, that is 3 into 10 power 8, 10 to the power of 8, hc over, divided by lambda I. It is given already, 1800 angstrom, that is 1800 into 10 power minus 10 meter, minus W, you know, you already found that value as 8.01 into 10 power minus 19 joule Celsius. Please get this answer. Please update this first term value first. What is the value of the first term?
3.03 into 10 to the minus 19, sir.
The overall value you said, no? 3.0 something. I am asking about this value, first one. Okay, your answer is correct. 3 point something into 10 power minus 10, it is correct.
0.01103, sir. 0.01103 into 10 to minus 16.
Okay, here the 10 power minus 19 is there. No, try to express this overall value as 10 power minus 19 only for our convenience. Just what will be this multiplier? It will be 11 point something. You said 0.11 something, no? Can it be 11 point something?
0.5.
Okay, 0.5. Okay, 11.05 into 10 power minus 19 minus this W value. Okay, then as you said, it will be 3 point, tell me. 3 point, how much it is?
0.4.
3.04 into 10 power minus 19 joules. Okay, this is for the kinetic energy of the photoelectrons. Okay, this is for the kinetic energy of the photoelectrons. Fine. Now, you can easily find out the corresponding de Broglie wavelength. You know, if I know the kinetic energy, if I know the energy of the particle, I can use the desired lambda equation and I can get the corresponding lambda. You know, the de Broglie wavelength lambda is equal to h upon square root of 2m into e, where m is the mass of the particle, e is the kinetic energy. In this case, shall I write this as ek instead of simply e? I'll just write it as ek. Of course, it is energy, kinetic energy, h divided by 2me. Now substitute 6.63 into 10 power minus 34 divided by 2 into which is the mass now? Mass of electron. The mass of electron, anyway it is electron, no? Photoelectron, 9.1 into 10 power minus 31 kg into the EK you found just now, that is 3.04 into 10 power minus 19. Okay. Please calculate this answer. De Broglie wavelength of photoelectron, that is lambda, is equal to, okay, it is 8.91 into 10 power minus 10 meter. Okay, this is what the de Broglie wavelength of the photoelectrons generated. That is around 8.9 angstrom. If you want, you can even express that in angstrom, but need not to worry of the unit, SI unit, anyway it is there. Okay, that's how you found the de Broglie wavelength of the photoelectrons. Okay. Let me take the next one. What is the potential difference through which an electron should be accelerated to attain its de Broglie wavelength to 0.02 nanometer? Okay, what is given now? The given is the de Broglie wavelength of the electron, that is given. This de Broglie wavelength is 0.02 nanometer. Take this in meter, that is 0.02 into 10 power minus 9 meter. Okay? Next is, what we supposed to calculate? We supposed to calculate the potential difference through which the electron should be accelerated. Okay, how much the voltage should be given for the corresponding electron, that is V should be determined. The potential difference V should be calculated. We know that for electrons, de Broglie wavelength lambda is equal to 12.26 divided by square root of V into 10 power minus 10 meter. Okay, well, expressing the de Broglie wavelength in different forms, for charged particle which is accelerated by a potential of V, we have a general equation of lambda is equal to, what is that equation? H upon square root of 2m q into V. Okay, where q is the charge. For electron, E will be taken. M is the mass of the electron is known, and H is the value of known thing. If you are substituting this, you had the equation of this form directly. Okay, need not to worry of this equation at this juncture. You just go directly for the resultant equation of this. You substitute the value of lambda and find out the V. Rearrange this equation. We suppose to get the V value, no? The potential value, no? Rearrange this. I am just give the rearranged version of this equation. The square root of V, that is equal to 12.26 into 10 power minus 10 divided by the lambda. On squaring both sides, we have the accelerating potential V. V, that is equal to 12.26 into 10 power minus 10 divided by the lambda, square it, which is equal to substitute and get the answer. Don't skip the substitution part. Unfortunately, if you are not getting the final answer correctly, at least thus up to substitution part you will be get the marks. Maybe one mark will be deducted, say, if you are not getting the correct answer. Just one mark will be deducted, not much than that. You are substituting the things.
Sir, 3757.6.
Tell me, 3 7, repeat it please.
3757.
Huh.
0.69.
Okay, 3757 volt. Okay, thank you.